Hello everyone, this is just a video tutorial I've made on using Spark for the Firefox 3 live chat. Here's how things are. I'm going to really do things here. The arrows that are up closest to the top are the things I'm mentioning first, second, down, and so on. So I believe I should get started, running out of time here. Anyhow, as you can see, the first arrow is pointing to the username slot. That's where you put your username, of course, after you've made an account. The second arrow is pointing to the password slot, where you're going to put your password, of course. Anyone can do that, I believe. Next is your server slash IP port, where you're going to put that. That's just the IP. They'll give it to you when you sign up and stuff, and you can just put it there. And the last arrow you see is the login. Once you log in, everything's good to go. Okay, so once you're logged in, this little box will pop up and it'll say contributors on it, of course. As you can see here, the little red box I have right now is the users. Anybody who's logged in will be there, including admins and so forth. It'll also tell you everyone's status, whether or not they're online or off or unavailable or set to do not disturb or something like that. I'll go over settings later. Okay, so next off, what I have marked in the red is chat. This basically is in this first room, as you can see. I'm here. This is the contributors room. Everyone's going to be here. Anybody logged on, they'll talk in here. This is also where you kind of hang out and stuff like that. So you can ask your questions here if you don't know the answer to other people's questions. Not only that, when you open a new box or start taking someone's question, it'll be just like this, and you just type in there and answer their questions from there. Okay, so this little box I have up at the top, all filled out, is your chats. Whatever chats you have open, you'll be clicking back and forth through these pretty much the whole time you do a chat. It's annoying, but I wish there was a short key to it, but there's not. You just gotta be used to it. You can just... all the chats that you get from other people to help people will go there, plus the contributors one, which is basically the conference room. Okay, so basically what I've done here is put a bunch of arrows, which kind of makes it confusing, but I just need to get a lot done real quick. As you can see, the very first arrow is pointed to where it says away under my name. Under my name... It and under your name, when you start helping, it's your status. You can click on that, and a pop down list will pop up, and you can choose to set away and on the phone, do not disturb, and things like that. Second is the arrow pointed to log out after it says support work group. That is when you're logged into support work group, which is where you'll get chats and things like that if you're set to available, pretty much. And you can log in and out of that. Okay, so the next arrow, I do believe, is... there's two kind of put together, but the one on the left, it says, is under online agents. When you click that, you'll see everybody who's helping at the same time and who's there, really. Next, you'll see, is the one on the right. But they're kind of the same height. Put right next to the one in the middle, the big giant one. Sorry, I should have labeled these. Forgive me. Anyhow, it says current chats. You can click on that and see who has what. Who's doing what. Who's talking to who about what question. So if you don't have a chat, you might want to look through there and see if you can help anybody. Or if you have a quick solution to one of those. The very last one says queue activity. And that one will tell you how many people are in the queue, what the current wait time is that most people are waiting to get there, and stuff like that. So basically on the very bottom one now, the very long one on the bottom, it says contacts. Contacts is just basically anybody in your lists or things like that. I have never really used that, so forgive me for that. The next one says conferences. When you click that, you can get back into the contributors thing if you lose it. if you accidentally X out. The very last one says fast path, which is the screen you're seeing now with the queue activity and online agents and current chats and all that. And I believe that's it for now. Sorry this video was a bit fast and a bit confusing, and I didn't have the arrows labeled. I had to go through this pretty quickly. Anyhow, I really hope this helps anybody new to Spark. I'm glad you're helping us and everybody here. And yeah, you have a good night now.